My name is Thomas William Ghettogeek Owoo. The name mostly originated from Ghana, West Africa, attributed to the person that society supposedly called my father. My loving mother came from the place they named me after, St. Thomas, Jamaica. My cultural complexity gets deeper as I'm British-born, well-spoken, but I still at times subtly drop slang. I guess I'm just a product of being a first-generation Afro-Caribbean who's played within the system of Her Majesty's land. At times I found it hard to find my place within my family. Dad was rarely there to be seen, and when he was, the abusive put-downs and beats was the beginnings of life's bittersweet symphony. I'm not playing on your sympathy, but sirens were the sounds I could hear when CID used to bang on the door. Mum shed tears and I watched confused with fear as they looked for my two notorious brothers. A string of robberies fitted their description. Soon the family name was stained as the convicts, but I was convinced I wouldn't follow their path with conviction. Path with conviction. With Mum working 20-hour cleaning shifts, it's often quiet being home alone. What's the point crying when no one will hear me? I decided to make a diary of rhymes so I could find a way to communicate to myself clearly. One of my brothers developed manic bipolar when I was 10. He was 18. Naively, I thought I could learn to cure him. So I got a 2-1 BSc degree in psychology, specialising in developmental cognitive science and psychopharmacology. Even though I was the youngest of 7, all I ever wanted was to be my brother's keeper. I realised at 21, perhaps I couldn't help them, but I could help prevent that pain happening to someone else. They say prevention is better than a cure. So I decided to see if the letters PGCE could be the key to unlock those minds of those unknown branded brothers who's lost their souls to the city. First, I was a teaching assistant, learning mentor, and then a literacy intervention coordinator. The latter's what gave me a taster that these children's minds are like a canvas and I could be their painter. Picture this. 11-year-old boys' literacy levels are below par and I get given the responsibility to make a mark and clean up their mar. They reluctantly come into the room, so I decided to drop a bar and say, "Hey, let's do some rap." Well, I called it that. I got my brazen brethren to come in to spit rhymes about Mahatma Gandhi and he linked his own experiences to his ancestral tree. My reasoning was they needed to develop more positive self-identity because boys don't always picture themselves in a positive as they yet to develop from the experiences of the negative. Just like my brothers. I found a way to help them discover their own trees, creating poetry through role models rooted from their own ancestry. Afghans, Iraqis, Congolese and Somali, ensuring they got their much-needed 5A to C's in GCSE. After 14 years of teaching, I realised those limited times I was able to drop rhymes was a highlight of what I delivered at school. So that's all I want to do now. Yes, I'm a teacher, but I'm more of a poet. And my name is Thomas William Ghettogeek Owoo.